Here comes Speed Racer, he's a demon on wheels.
What's going on, Power Squad? Will Power here, and I'm with
Ethan Crow.
And we're here walking this tear down lot that Ethan came across. How did we came across this one?
Just through cold calling. We have three properties that we're gonna walk today and just show you guys, you know, how to calculate the ARV and kind of just the basics of walking properties, because we're not driving for dollars today.
Yeah, yesterday we had our second ride along, it was great, and tomorrow we got our third. With the lots, like you said before, you want to find out the ARVs of the lot, and you want to get that lot at 15%.
10 to 15.
10 to 15%. I'm not sure if you guys heard that, because Will is speed racing.
Go speed racer, go.
But
so here we got the foundation.
This is probably worth, oh damn, look at all those Coke bottles, old Coke bottles.
All right, well, you would want to buy this at 10 to 15% of the ARV.
So that's really it for this property, to be honest. We got to go back
to the office and just run some numbers on it and shoot them over an offer.
All right.
This is the first one out of three today.
All right, on to the second one.
What's going on, Power Squad? Will Power here, and I'm with
Ethan Crow.
You already know, and welcome to the Power Show. There was a burn house that we came across driving for dollars. Ethan reached out to the dude, and
yeah, we're just gonna be teaching you guys, you know, just the basics of walking distressed properties. We got a row of duplexes here.
Yeah, one, two, three, four, five duplex and two lots.
Yeah, so we're gonna check those out. We already went and walked the first lot. If you guys didn't know already, with lots, you wanna get that lot at 10 to 15% of the ARV. And I think that's the buyer's buy price, right?
Yeah.
So that's your MAO, really. And then you wanna take your percentage of what you wanna make off.
Exactly. If the ARVs are 400K, you want to use 10% of that, you're looking at $40,000.
Yeah, we're about to go and walk this one. He said that we can go inside, but it's boarded. So I don't know.
Yeah, we'll just walk the outside and see what's up.
We'll try and get inside of it if we can. It looks like that board can come off.
All right, so we're here walking the houses. I'm gonna go that one first. This is the one that is his or what?
This is the one that's his. All right. We don't have permission to walk into the other one, so I wouldn't.
Right.
I'm not trying to get into any trouble doing this.
Right here, you can tell these are full rehab, full gut jobs. So basically, what you want to check on when you're walking your house like this is a full rehab, a gut job, that the foundation is good. You don't want to see any slants, any dips, any cracks. So that's all you really care. If the foundation is good, then you can build from there. Yeah, there's not much we can see here. Oh, I don't need to see the inside. I already know what's up just by looking at it. So check it out.
Yeah, it's probably gonna be a full gut in the inside. Maybe it's already gutted. So let's go walk around the outside.
That's a bunch of like trees and shit.
Someone hollering at us?
No, it's not at us.
It looks like that one's got a lockbox on it, but we already came through
here. Yeah, we came through here and we left sticky notes.
So it looks like the foundation's checking up. This guy's an old man.
Yeah, the foundation's good.
Yeah, he couldn't really. I'll let you go first so I can give you a video. But he was really hard to understand. So we got some foundation issues right here. That's boarded up. I don't know if you want to show them that.
Nah.
But that's not a big deal.
No, that's not a big deal at all.
Nothing too major. Just replace the bricks. You're really just looking for the make sure the house isn't leaning.
Exactly. So, or any stress cracks there.
So I'm sure Sid would like this one.
Oh, that's true. That's right.
We'll see what price we can get it under at, but he also has another house. He didn't tell us to go and walk it, but also I'm not sure if he knew which one I was talking about, which property. So we're going to go and walk both of them today and just...
The other one that we're going is his?
Yes, sir. So we're going to go. The roof looks pretty decent.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what that is up there, Will. But...
Well, I don't know if they'll keep it as a duplex or do an addition and make it a single family home.
I'd say maybe a duplex because it's got duplexes all across here. So
the buyer will know what they want to do. They'll keep it as a...
Yeah, so I was actually...
As a duplex, or they're going to make it a single-family home, and they're going to have to add square footage.
Most definitely. And I was actually thinking, so yesterday, if you guys watched the video that's newly posted with Dell, I was explaining to Dell how you kind of want to make the house as a 3-2, which is true, but now that I'm thinking about it, you really just leave it up to the investor, so...
Yeah, but most investors, that's what they're going to do.
Yeah, so you can price your ARV on a 3-2 and tell the investor that, but... Sometimes I'm sure you might just want to price that thing at
These are all
just the normal.
Since it's brick, the foundation is good. You can see right here clearly. Up here. Let's get the sun out right here. Boom.
So, Will, what do you think about that? Because let's say I'm pricing my ARV as a 3-2. Because in our eyes, we would make it a 3-2.
Yeah.
Do you think that's good idea, or should I just price the house as it is?
No, it's a good idea.
Because what if the investor doesn't care about that? And when
well,
I
then
give
he'll
him
tell you, oh, I'm not going to do it like that.
The house has
another lot right here.
Price the house out as is, or what do you suggest?
That's a
because you
question.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That'll be a learning experience once I figure it out. I'll most definitely let you guys know for the frizzle.
Yo.
All right, Power Squad. We're here at the third property. Come check this out.
Y'all look at this, man.
When was this? This is probably like...
Oh, shit.
This is like a month ago, dude. And it's still got my sticky note on it. That is crazy. These sticky notes are from Kroger. You guys want to check them out. They're Kroger sticky notes. Man. They're doing us good. I don't know. I don't think we can get inside. It's got walls. It's probably just full repair. Let's go check out... the backyard and see if we can get in down there. Mm-hmm. The foundation looks good so far.
Yeah, and most definitely one tip.
You guys are coming out here walking these properties, you know, make sure you got long pants on and wear
no heels.
Yeah.
I don't think we can get under here.
Wear like decent shoes.
But see, the foundation looks good.
It's just looking like a pool down there, most likely. And do you think that other property was already gutted?
Which one? Where we were at? The duplex?
Yeah.
Probably. If not, it's probably already included in the price because that's a full gut job. So. If it's not, it still needs to be
done. Right?
Yeah. Part of the demo.
Oh man, they were just money for real. He said, fuck the stocks, man.
Oh, he told you that?
No, he didn't.
Oh. Alright, so there it is. Woods. Yeah, we ain't going in there. Alright.
But from looking in the windows, I could just tell that it probably doesn't need to be torn down, so I could price it at a full repair, but I'm gonna price it in the middle of a full repair and then a full gut, just to leave me some space, you know? Or I might just price it as a full gut.
No, it's a full gut.
What would you say a full repair is, Will?
When you don't gotta do like roof and windows, it's like a cosmetic.
But it's
all right.
Cosmetic would be cheaper.
Yep. So we're done here with the third house. We lost a piece of the microphone, so we're gonna go back to the duplexes to see if it's there, and then heading back to the crib, do some cold calling and marketing. Boom. What's going on, Power Squad? So we're heading back to the crib to do. Actually, no, we're not skip tracing. We're just gonna be doing some cold calling. I'll be working on the marketing. Walk three properties today: one lot, one duplex, and a house.
Decent day. really just going back to the house to run up some numbers on those so I can get my offer sent out. And yeah, that's about it. And then if I don't got to go into work, then I'll just cold call the rest of the day. But who knows with my job, you know, they're acting up. That's all I got to say.
They're hating.
Yeah, for real.
All right, and we lost the microphone, so we're back to square one. Somewhere in the car.
I hope I find that shit.
Yep. No, we'll get another one. Not a big deal. All right. Tomorrow we got our third ride along. Shout out to ATL Scoop. See you tomorrow, Todd.
His name is Todd the God, right?
Todd the God.
Hopefully we can have. We'll see what I can do with cold calling, so maybe we can get him a walkthrough. If not, we'll just take him to the treehouse.
We'll take him to the treehouse.
So,
you haven't heard from Kristen?
It's weird. I don't know what's up with people, man. They're not answering their phone. I don't know if they're on extra vacation, because I think school is still out.
Maybe, I don't know.
So, maybe they're with children, their kids, and they're, you know, on vacay. But, I don't hear by them next week, I don't know what to do. But Will taught me to just keep following up until they say no. So
yep.
That's what I've been doing every other day. You'll hear from me every other day.
Hot lead till you get a no. All right, see you tomorrow.
This is fucked, dude. It's all the girls that work there now, they're only working there for like a week or two. Because they're on break.
It's like my glasses are like tilted, slanted.